We don't cover Pik Kaiser by like one big blind, which sucks, but let's just hold versus queens, have a 70 big blind stack and go deep. I literally failed all the time today with kings. This is the one time. Alright? Kings, make me proud. Let's pray together. GL, GL. Yup, chip lead pot if we win this. Lul. Let's do that. Alright, no ace. No two other, please.
Come on, boys! Come on! Chip leader, Lero! Come on, man!
Do we have a final table coming up? No queen and we're on there. Yup. Final table there on the 215th Thursday thrill. Do I have a cool sound for that one? No. I don't. Do I have one? Do I have any cool sound effect that you can put? We have that one. Alright, that got me pumped up a bit. Are you ready for the FT? Can we see some rockets in the chat? We just got the blue rocket emote today. Can we just see a wall of rockets? What else do I have there? Oh, classic. Classic. Woo! I'm pumped up. Let's go. Alright. All right, let's do some social media posts. Follow me on social media, facebook.com/Bolero, instagram.com/Bolero, and then twitter.com/HenryBühler, or just look for Bolero there and you will find me. Also you can put in sub mode now, I'm quickly doing social media stuff. Alright, still post on facebook.com/Bolero as well. God, I hate Facebook. Facebook is just so outdated, overrated. Just debates me to tilt. Let's see if we actually use Facebook. Check it out. Isn't it this guy can make a comeback? Well, I hope not. Oh, sorry, I put into someone already. Okay. Rip the plebs. Still love you. But, you know, for spoiler reasons and shit. Can't do it. Yo, Andrew. Home is whenever I'm with you. Andrew with the full year. Pure cockroach indeed. Welcome back home, dude. Nice to see you. Nice to see you, man. Hope things are good. Thank you. Welcome back home. So these are the payouts. 615 locked up plus our bounty. And it goes all the way up to 6.2k for first plus bounty. So first base should be around 12 grand. Which is quite nice. Oh, man. There are some blue rockets in the chat. I'm getting in there. That's a lot of rockets. Let's fucking go, guys. Straight to the moon. With that shark soup graph. Fuck off, Poker Bros. It's nice. We cash for 1,200 now already. Profitable. Third profitable day in a row. But, you know, let's win the millions. I'm gonna put the payouts on the screen as soon as someone busts. I mean, I could put them on right now and put them on the over the chat or something. Maybe you should just see a knockout here. Whew. Aggressive rejam. What the fuck? Alright, I guess I'll put them over the chat when we're in sub mode. What was the other card? Was it another queen? No, it was a nine of spades. Still a pretty good card. Just gonna put this in here for now. Until. Oh yeah, that doesn't work, obviously. We'll just put it in like this for now. Hope that's okay. I feel like it's better than nothing. This is actually quite interesting. I think we're calling. I mean, we're obviously calling, but we could raise as well. I mean, we're just not folding. Like, I wouldn't hate a raise here. Don't have many stats on him yet. It's just, these are interesting fine tables because you have to figure out if, whether you want to go for the bounty in certain spots or the ladder and stuff. So we have to see how much we can do. Moin moin, servus, das ist Vegas. Nice, das ist Dawson back. Was geht? Never forget Alaska. Let me come home. Home is whenever I'm with you. Turbo Fish Pie, welcome home, dude. Thanks, what's up? Let's go. I think I should call that part once. He's just gonna have like a lot of Steel Broadways and Steel Connectors and shit that he just bets once. I think I just take my shoulder maybe with the 9 here. If it like Queen 8 of Spades here or Queen 10 of Spades, I would bluff, I think. I'm not quite sure. But I think a 9 is definitely good enough. Let's hope he's like 4s or something. Ace 3. Okay. Seems okay. Damn. Home is whenever I'm with you. Thanks, handsome Henry. Welcome back home, dude. Cheers. Let's go. Fuck me, dude, another fighting table with the stream. Just put the camera like this. I want to sit up straight so we can focus the max. 66 blinds. Things are good. Thanks, rich boy. Do, 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 do. Tenzi's all, yeah, kind of a weird rejam. So let's have a quick look here. 26 blinds over there. He has a bunch of chips. He's kind of mid-stackish with him. 20 blinds, 14 blinds, 27. So there's a bunch of these stacks. I think those 14 to 20 blinds. Then we have two mid-stacks, two big stacks. But he's a really big stack. I'm just like somewhat big stack. Mid-stack over here. Okay. We're not getting too out of line. We just wait for our spot. Stack people. I'm in a couple of thousand here. Should be a fun one. Doop doop doo doo bop. Diesen Board. Wesentlich Mr. Check Race himself. I'll check back to check, obviously, with the sweet king. It doesn't have any natural bluffs here because there's some ace high floats and 4x that he bluffs with now. I think usually I just have a snap call here. Let me just check. Yeah, he's too good to fold king 7 here. Nice. And he joins the 4 into the bluff. Like, this is the reason, like, because it's good players, you can call there with the king 7. I mean, it's like a snap call, obviously, because we are so high up in my range usually. But just versus, it's especially nice with good players. It's a nice little pot there. All right. Do we have the first knockout of this fine table? Yeah, Easter, let's just not like spam about it right now. I will take care of it later. Like, you know me, man. I'm obviously in there. I'm going to fight. I'm going to figure shit out, okay? It's just... Let's leave this topic aside for now, please. Dude, like, I'm here for you guys when shit like that happens, okay? Yeah. Alright, no tenon, we have our first letter, or heart. GG. Alright, let's put them on the screen. Yeah, I think we leave them on for now like this. Yeah. Man, these guys have like over 1k in bounties. Like him and Wesley, pretty solid. Actually, he deserves a great drag for that bluff. Let's see a flop with the queen 10. Pretty good one. Sushi ends up like being a pretty clear check call for two streets on a board texture like that. We'll see. Then usually tough spot on the river, but it's also a board where he does love checking. We have a clear check call on the turn here. I think there's no real other line here. River just comes down to like, yeah, something else that I would consider there. Hmm. Let's hit the river here. We're not winning this hand, I can tell you that. I mean, maybe if he has like a king 7 suited here, we might win. But I guess he's bluffing that. So, yeah. Hmm, this kind of sucks actually. I don't have many asex in my range. This is a great spot for him to bluff river. Yeah, this is a really nice spot to overbet. I really have a few asex here, like ace 8. And then maybe ace check. I mean, I guess I have ace check. Yeah, I don't 3-bet that preflop. But I 3-bet ace queen, ace king pre, so I don't have many asex here. Besides ace 10, but I'm not sure. I really like this on his end. It's quite a tough spot for me. But yeah, can't call. Interesting. Do my best, Henry. Thanks, mate. Right, come on, come on. One more ladder. I want that. I mean, we already have a four-figure score. But kind of five-figure scores sounds kind of cool. Mm-hmm. What is that? 7-6 of spades versus queen check. Right, let's play this one first. Actually, I'm gonna limp this versus these two guys. Hmm, it's kind of tempting to hero call river here with queen high and with like 5-6, 7-5, 7-6 all breaking. It just depends if he bluffs those. Always, or how often he does bluff him. Because he probably gives up a bunch as well. Nice. That was pretty sweet. Nice, squeeze Lero taking it down, 750k, good pots guys, let's keep it rolling. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. 2 of 8, playing good poker. Let's give it up. Thanks, Ali. Yeah, I'm trying not to forget Twitch questions, but if there's a situation like this where we're playing for that much money, I usually sometimes ignore it. But yeah, feel free to ask along. And if you wait for 3 minutes, I still haven't answered your question, feel free to post it again. But I'm really trying my best. Like, I don't miss many messages during an entire stream. But obviously, I have to pay attention to every hand, because otherwise, I have to figure... If I didn't see him flat 6 times suited earlier, I might not squeeze the ace 10 off and shit like that, you know? So these little things add up quite nicely. We're almost fighting for the chip lead now. Damn, boat over boat. I don't mind the fish winning that one. Respecting the regulars. That's fucking sick, though. Blind versus blind, boat over boat. Nice spot to happen that at on the final table. Wow, that's so sick. Chip lead, Puck Champ. What's up, Didi? Good timing. How you doing, man? Man, I pull with that fucking big bounty, man, and 20 blinds. I want that. That's just looking real good. I think just open jamming this, given their bounty sizes for 250 blinds. For 25 blinds, not for 250. Nice. I'm gonna fold the 63 anyhow. Thanks, this is your... Okay, yeah, I have to be careful. I don't want to get too in depth usually when I'm on a funny table, because these other guys are watching, so I don't like to explain the strategy too much. I will say, like, I can say a couple of things, but just saying like that, I don't want to explain like every little thing I do. Yeah, just because I know like all of the regulars here are watching and he's watching, so there might be like 2 people not watching at once. These other guys are all watching and they're all like really good regulars, so I have to be really, really careful. So, yeah. They will always see my card, so I don't want to get too out of line. Yeah, but I actually bounty finding tables are fucking insane, and it's tough to actually analyze it because on one hand you want to do like chip EV decisions, other side you want to like do minus chip EV decisions but plus dollar EV because you have the bounties. Then it's really important to not miss out on too much mini, like to be too carried away by these plus chip EV decisions to get bounties, because then it's tougher to get first and all the money's up top. So it's just a lot of things that you have to consider with your playstyle. I will get a bit into it, I guess. Just depends on the situation. But yeah, if you're second or third, first in chips, sometimes it's important to like make a fold and not to get the bounty, but then play for the first place. It's just tough to say as like a general answer. Blinds go up. Happy so far with how the final table went. We had a nice little start. Just like some nice pots going down. Let's get to the million mark, guys. Oh, rip. Yeah, the VODs get deleted after a while. Oops, that's the ladder. Did you rejam that preflop? Seems like a profitable rejam for sure, but just interesting to see. By the way, that's nice. He's the guy with the Lex avatar. I was afraid of him. I'm definitely raising over him. Like, don't even start limping my small blind dude. Even though this hand is not ideal for it, it's just important to like send a message in a spot versus a recreational, I think. I'm probably just giving up here, to be honest. He's not that like that loose preflop so far, and then he should connect really well with this board, so I don't think we need to like get too carried away here. I might like just go for a little bet on the river to fold him off ace highs. Right, now it's just value bet. Hope he has ace four in cards. Nice winner pot as well. Thanks, man. And yeah, we're going to do 1K now, just in payouts. Keep it rolling. Interesting spot for him with like an ace check here. I assume that's what he has. Maybe an ace queen, even. Nah, just an ace check, I guess. Maybe an ace 10. Because, like, if he loses that one, it kind of hurts his stack a lot. He's kind of in a nice position being a chip leader. With like, look at how, like, there's so many guys with like 20 blinds right now. ICM pressure is kind of like, it's pretty bad for these guys. He gets the fold. Thanks, dude. And thanks for the sub as well. Just gonna open jam this again for like 23 blinds effective. it's just gotta be like super, super profitable, and none of them really want to bust with each other guys being short, you know? Stuff. What do you say? Yeah, I know what you mean. It's just tough to say. Like, I can be quite aggressive with these guys because everyone is kind of short. Yeah, I never reviewed the check 10 call. It's probably still fine. Didi's brother lives in New Zealand. Didi has been there like a couple of times over the last 2 years. They live in like a really fucking nice place. I saw some Instagram stuff from him. Good stuff. Boom, boom, boom. So a pretty consistent start to the final table. And it was like the king's hand. And then we're just like cruising. High roll Alero. Oh yeah, where did you grow up off the on the island? Ah, it's like somewhere in the northeast. Because I saw it some I remember like 2 years ago in your stream we talked about it a bit. Somewhere in the northeast, I remember. I forgot the name though. I mean, he's not afraid right now. I mean, with these stacks. Boop, 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 boop. All right, 35%, guys. Come on. King 4. 9. Nothing we can do. I mean, this is a chippy VJM with King 4, obviously. Especially great with his bounty. Kind of nice to win the 60-40s on the final table, but I shouldn't complain. I mean, I shouldn't complain, but I won't complain. This is kind of odd. Man, that was $700 plus the ladder. That's like a $1,100 hand. Plus, obviously, the chips, which are worth more. Lul. Oh, come on, he's there. Just shut the fuck up, please. All right, good luck with Queens. Not this topic again. Ah. Nice. Omni's four on the final table. Try a little sway. Nice. Let's get back to a milli. Well, to 900k and then a milli. Doop, doo, 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 doo. Yo, what's up, dear my TR? It's gonna be a long final table. I feel still great. Just gotta stay focused here. It's not always that easy to just say stay focused, you know, but I'm gonna try my best. Parksville, yeah, Nanaimo, exactly. Or Nanaimo, whatever. Yeah, it was, I think it's called Nanaimo, yeah. Yeah, when I first came to Vancouver Island, I landed, it's like, oh, the ferry drove me to Nanaimo. I do remember now. Kington off, man. In the famous hand. And we just check fold in the flop. What's up, Ezekielowski? And we're probably losing here. And we could bluff. But then, like, on this board, I'm gonna have, like, check 10 and all that shit, so I don't really want to. The name sounds like a place taken out of a movie. Yeah, a bit. Damage flux. Oh shit. Oh shit! What? Do we have a double KO here? Nope. That's a sick 2-outer to hit, I have to say. But now he has 600 chips and a $450 bounty. That could be fun. Aces? No, not quite. Alright, just don't pay attention here, Vasilich. For once in your life, don't pay attention. Just you guys, don't pay attention. Alright. This is a profitable flat with 400 free bucks in a pot. Yes, definitely. Let's flop two pair here or something. Kind of a nice spot from the jam, quite wide. But I think we have to call 10-4 and I think we can't redo anything else here. Alright, now we fold. Big pot Pokemon, he just snap calls it like he doesn't care one bit. Ace 3, he's like, wow, 8-5 with the flop. He stays in, yeah. Wow, I would have won a huge pot here. Because if he folds, I might call his jam. I'm just gonna call here. Wow, we're down to 6 now. Oh, baby. Hopefully he gets it in. Yeah, I think we just bet small here. No! Been sick if he got it in that hand. I know we just fold. I Wow, that's such a sick 10 to hit. Holy fuck, man. Now here's all the chips. I guaranteed over 2,000 bucks at this point, and I mean, it's pretty unlikely he goes out, so that would be another 500. Not bad. I kind of want more than that, to be honest. I feel pretty good. Let's run deep. Yeah, let's raise it. What the fuck? Whoa, they missed it. They missed it. Holy shit. Yeah, I think we see that here. Nice. Okay, no check. No check. That's 450 bucks right there, boys. Holy shit, I didn't pay attention, man. Fuck. That's so nice. Alright, we made over 3,000 bucks in this tournament already. Let's go. Oh my god, how did I not pay attention in that spot? I mean, obviously he can't, but I think these two guys have to call like everything. Maybe I'm off. Ooh, 9-6 off versus a min. Yeah, we gotta call versus a min. Not a worse flop. Nope, I didn't want to move the overlay. Back into your place. And I think for 700 bucks, we're calling here, right? That's not that worth. Wow, that's close. I'm not sure. All right, 36%, come on. That doesn't look good with that on the flop. Dead on flop. Chase dog with the sub. Oh, what did I see there? Yep, welcome home, dude. Thank you. So yeah, I like to call with King9, I think that's fine. 700 bucks, like, we're doing just fine versus this range with King 9 when he jams like 8 9 there and shit like that, 10 9. A lot of stuff we're flipping against and a lot of 60 40s as well. I think a small bet is fine here. Actually, I looked into the spot, yeah. King is either a check or a 2/3 bet, I think. I like a 2/3 bet here. Full at 4 5, 4 6, 6 4. Ace 4, Ace 5, you know, just a bunch of stuff. There's the 4, 3, 4 suited of like hearts and shit, you know, just gotta go. Thanks for Mr. Foden, Ace, nice suit to me in the 3150 bounty test. I shipped that turn a few minutes ago. And drops us up, man. Karma. Kind of. GG, dude. Congrats. Happy. Happy that I folded to you in that case. That's sick. I think usually we have like a big, like a large range, or like a big sizing range bet there. I think then we can just check it. Yeah, I think we take shoulder value here. Wow, that's tight. All right, 3 out of 5, guarantee 3K. Let's go. Definitely a fun final table so far, man. Lots of action. let's call here. No, let's check fold here. Scat money folding 10-4 off. So we just bought the check raise turn. I don't think I can call there, but check raise seems interesting. It would be a lovely spot for the big blind to rejam his pocket sevens here. Hold. 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 Come on. Come the fuck on. Try number two. We picked out. We pick it up, man. Biggest bounty in the tournament. 2 out of 4. Next ladder, guys. Gend it over. Holy shit, 4.2K at this point? What? Sick heater. I don't know what GG in Greek is, but GG, mate. Alright, it's really nice to knock out the regulars, man. Let's keep it up. Almost a milli. The Lord. She is Egyptian. Watch the re-race. Ooh. Is that a milli? Oh, close to that milli. Man, sick one. That feels good. Nice little 4K score here. Holy shit, man. That heater is like... The heater is real. Ooh. Could be a pot. Force usually not spot where you see too many bluff barrels. Or too many barrels in general. Okay. Ship it, chip leader. Ooh. Let's see if he calls 10-9 suited here. Yeah, it's 10. Okay. I mean, it's 10's different than 10-9 suited, obviously. That's an interesting note. Alright, so these two guys exchange their stacks. Not great for me. Egyptian legend, dude. Is he German? No. Guess it means something else in English. In Ukrainian. Thank you, I Egyptian, and welcome home to Unholy Light 13. Welcome home, dude. Thank you. Let's go. I think we're just rejamming 30 here. We crossed the 3-bit call. I guess rejamming is just a little easier with that hand. Good luck. One stop, can't stop. Let's go.
Time machine.
We're just cruising, man. Like, really important flip there with the 8s, obviously. And then, like, nice little squeeze getting it through and stuff. It's just nice when these things are also working out, you know? Become hot. Egyptian again, thank you, dude. To Azagalovsky. Cheers, dude. Welcome home, man. Holly94 with the Twitch Prime sub. Thank you. Welcome home. Holy fuck. Thanks, guys. And girls, thanks everyone. I'm not looking much at chat right now because forehanded obviously needs a lot of attention. Pick up on reads and stuff pretty early. I can't fold it, I just can't. I kind of tried, he's pretty tight, but I can't. I mean, King 10 off his button, I mean, what the fuck? I'm expecting a lot of leads here from the big blind. Yeah, we're not bluffing here. I think big blind has a fairly strong range in this spot, to be honest. Ooh. Queen Jackie had nice one. That was a quick 3-bet, dude. But yeah, I think we're just going with the 7s here. Good luck, guys. There's no very biggest store route here, right? But like pocket 8s or pocket 9s. Was he thinking about calling like an ace 10 off here or something? I guess we're getting slaughtered here. Nope, we're not. Nice, 1.1 million. Back into the chip lead. Yep. Good stuff. For the lulz, thank you, Henrik. Alright. Muted clip? Oh yeah, it could have happened that there was muted clips out there. Wait, let me quickly update Instagram again. So we're in the chip lead now, biggest bounty, most chips. Already locked up 1,800 plus 2.6k, so like over 4 grand. Let's get it. Instagram.com/Blair, by the way, boys. Hit that follow button. Was immer like a check here, was this regular with C-bet? Ooh, we see 3-bet. The music and dance. Let me sit up straight again. Very nice pants and clip. GTO pants, dude. Big pot poker, man. Was like check check flop bet turn bet river? Not really sure. Don't think he went for three streets given the size of the pot. But yeah, didn't really follow the action. Imagine he's like a king jack or something. If it was like check check flop bet turn bet river. Oh, it was just button. I thought it was a 3-bet pot still, but he folded, obviously. So, it's so this is cut off as a big blind. Yeah. Never mind. I hope he wins this hand. Whether it is with a fold here or a call. Oh, what did he call there? He had to have like a hand that he can't fold. King 9, I guess. Easy base call versus Veselik here. That bounty has my name on it. Alright, let's just fold at a size here. Nice. Blinds go up, man. This is a somewhat like quick final table, man. I'm the chip leader with like, oh, like we both are pretty tight, but with like 50 blinds. Well, now the question is just who gets that $800 bounty. I guess we limp this. Value slash protection bet flop. Yeah, again, easy call. See what the runout brings. It's not my most favorite turn, obviously, with flush draws getting there and 4-5 getting there. Oh, same counts for the river. I hope he just checks it back here with like check 4-10-4, check 6-10-6, which are like reasonable raises on the flop. He had 10 deuce. Seems not unreasonable to me. Yeah, I think we're calling here with 3-7. The $800 bounty is obviously worth quite a bit. He folds though. Now it's just time to hit the 4 of clubs on the turn. Clear call. We can almost raise with this sizing. Because now I open myself up to get raised from behind. Holy shit, 4 of clubs on the turn? Is that what I said? Is that what I said, ladies and gentlemen? Please don't have 7-8 here and ruin the fun for me. That would be indeed quite brutal. And when you reach a level of Rango where you can call turn cards, that's where shit really goes down. Alright, nice pot. I mean, this is a really fucking fucked up spot right now. Ah. I just want to see aces here and then see him all in. Alright, good luck, 8-6. Maybe this is just a rejam, actually. This could just be a rejam. Yeah, I don't think he makes the call with A7 over there. GG. With three-handed now. Now he has the biggest bounty. Now we just need to survive him. I don't have the same hammer pants anymore. Definitely raising his 7 suited here. Could actually make it 5x. Usually I would not see that here, but he showed like so many ace-x in these spots. I still don't think I should see that. I'm actually going to call turn. And now we just hope we chop it. Nice. Here at 10-9. Fuck. Whew, that works good. Let's limp this. We got a sub from I Bruton. Thank you, dude. Welcome home, man. I mean, King deuce and shit like that is a bluff here. If he raises, we just call. Just calls a nine. Yeah, I'm not really calling anything but a nine. All right, this is going in. Hopefully he just rejams. Nope, no deuces for him. C-bet here, on the larger side of things. Not betting this board all too often. Gonna bet turn again. He's like to check raise a lot of like straights into pairs on the flop. So besides like queen nine and some shit like that, he doesn't really pick up a lot on the queen or like queen check of clubs. So it's important to bet there for protection and like get more value from like 9-8 and stuff like that. We have a really nice deck here. I'm definitely gonna call here in position. This is recreational. I don't think he will ever check raise here, so I like a bet. And I think now we just check it down because he still has like pocket checks here without a diamond and shit like that, I think. And we could try to bluff him off that. No. But he could also have like ace five of hearts and shit, so I'm checking this. Yeah. But yeah, I don't think like, I think we're doing really, really good there on the river. So I kind of, it kind of makes sense just to bluff everything in some way. Sadly, no tens this time. Thanks for the great suggestions in chat, guys. Appreciate it. I should probably make it a bit bigger. He likes defending his big blind. Also, I think we are the same. We can just bet a third pot more often. Yeah, I made a mistake betting early, bigger earlier. I mean, with the tens, like, I just need to bet the sizing I want to bet with my hand, and that's all. I mean, he raised ace five. We should limp. Yep, seems like a cage bet. No. Both under a million. Doing good. Nice, nice, nice. Come on, 2 million. We're really playing them down nicely here. Ooh, baby. So he doesn't have a boat with kings here. It's nice that he is short, man. It would be really nice to bust him and then play him heads up. The whole page to notice, dude. Yeah. I like that he starts limping on the button with his deck size. It's a good flop. I think we can just go for a lead here. That's kind of what my hands wants to do. And in these limped pots, it doesn't really matter to focus much on balance or anything like that. Since he only has like a few 8x in his range, I kind of like this a lot with this hand. Now we're just checking it down pretty much. And lose, I guess. Nope, he has 6-7. That's awesome. Yeah. Just important to focus on what you want to do with your hand in a limp pot like that, I believe. We just busted blue 30, lost ace king to nines, classic. Classic flip, I mean, not classic to lose. Definitely not classic to lose. $1.8 million. I mean, maybe I should start raising, I don't know. It's a great turn. Hope he doesn't have like a check 7 or check 4 here, that would suck. Pretty bad, getting closer to the 2 million. That's pretty filthy. I gotta be careful here. Maybe I should start limping the button. Yeah, I will start limping buttons for sure. Sadly, too good. I mean, actually, I like a check raise here. No, I just like a check call. Yet king 9 seems reasonable. Fuck, I raised the button again. Almost 2 million. We're not really taking away chips from him, just from him pretty much, so. Easy to get a wrong picture here. It's definitely a hand I want to raise. Just too strong to like check it here, I think. Getting closer to 2 million. I mean, I think I didn't have like a single good hand in the small blind. We flop pretty good usually, yep, again. But it's not that I have like great starting hands. It's that the flop improves my hands a lot. Almost 2 million. One more hand. $2 million though. Like, we could only check to give him the chance to catch up, but no, not sure. He doesn't bluff much, you know, so he needs to hit. Man, we do hit a lot here. One point, 2.1. Thanks, Iggy Kid. Does he have a better value? 7? Yeah, I think so. Alright, just aces makes also sense. Yeah, it's close. We could just fold the river there. It's fucking close, honestly. But it, like, if I had like 7-8, I fold the river. King 7 is a problem. It's just a beat like Queen 7, 10 7, shit like that. So I like the call. Yeah, it's all good. It's all good. Under 2 million again. Just gotta get back. It's a really nice spot. I just hope we can cooler him and finally pick up a hand. A small bank can just limp call and then stack him and then play like in a nice heads-up match here. There's a monster. Cheers, dude. All the money's up top, so it's quite important to run good here. We only made over 5k, which is really nice. He loses the pot to him. Awesome. Blinds go up. He has under 20 blinds now. Definitely something that's going to be interesting here. We did bluff turn. Okay. Oh, baby. No. No! Maybe it's good, man. You never know with the kings. But still, kind of hurts. That's kind of nice to do more limping here. Stack size wise, just sucks. It's folding queen seven suited. Like, what a monster. I think betting and checking flop is fine. I think checking is a bit better, though. Is it really a clear call? Don't love the 6C L5 here. Pretty tempted to call there. Kind of nice for us though if he has that stack size. Nah, I can't really fold no mander here. Sadly, no jam. Fuck, I hate myself for checking the turn. It's just like because of his flop, bit tank and shit. Probably has a king here. Nice. Let's go, boys. Let's go. This is the fucking one, man. This is the fucking one, man. Let's fucking go, man. The snap rejam. Not even thinking about it. That's the play. No tank. There's no need for a fucking tank, man. Come on. Oh, fuck. Are we winning the thrill again? Are we winning the fucking thrill again? Let's do it, man. Let's fucking do it. Wow, sick. That's just a value 3 bet, I think. I mean, we don't really know him that well yet, but sick. Just drops the cold 4 instantly. Wow, this hurts my soul, okay. This is not a good start to heads up. Gotta be careful, man. He seems a bit active now, pre-flop. Holy fuck. Okay. What the fuck? It's funny when people just change their play styles completely when you're like heads up. No, I would have 3-bet called that one. Alright. Wow, this is fucking insane. Okay, I guess we start limping a bit. I guess he just had a couple of hands and stuff. The headset match, man. That got me worried for a second. That could have been a really odd headset match. I'm also a bit scared, also just calling here. Because I really don't want to like 3-bet fold this one. So the queen check from him. Yeah, we should call. Easy snap hero, just get the fuck out of here. The tilt after getting wrecked. Come on. Ooh, the 3x. Let's see what he does with the 3-bet. Good luck, come on. Oh. Oh God. Yeah!
We won it again! We fucking won it again, boys! We fucking did it again! We won the turn! Holy shit, one of these days! One of these fucking days, man! We're just fucking unstoppable, man! Un-fucking stoppable! We won the thrill again! Holy shit, one of these days, man!
2,500 viewers in here as we take down the thrill for the second time in 6 months. Wow! Oh, I mean, you want to be correct here, right? Let's have a quick look. 7229 67 62 6475 13,494,42. That's what we do. That's what we do on this channel, boys. We win tournaments and run deep in the milli, I guess. Unbelievable, man.